I'm embarking on an epic adventure. From spectacular natural landscapes to the busiest cities in the world.
我来到中国，探索这个古老文明的宝藏。
I find this really very special indeed.
我想了解绵延数千年的中华传统文化，如何持续影响并塑造了这个伟大的国家。
I've really been looking forward to seeing this. And to truly understand the secrets of a country's soul, I think you need to immerse yourself in its art.
所以我将从这儿开启我的探秘之旅。我这次的旅程将从黄浦江边开始，在繁忙的大都市上海。我来这里参观一件有着3000多年历史的标志性青铜鼎。这口鼎是它的主人专门为其曾祖父打造的。我在中国南方和廖家人在一起，他们正在为一年一度的清明节做准备。我还将看到一顶精美绝伦的朱金木雕花轿，据说耗费了上万个工时才打造完成。
This is the most OTT piece of splendiferous bling I think I've ever seen.
我来这里追溯中国的艺术与祖先，以及或许称得上是最珍贵的中国宝藏——家庭，这三者之间的古老联系。
新婚快乐！
每年早春，约5亿生活在中国城市的人们便会踏上返乡的旅程，只为能和家人一起度过新春佳节。这是一个当代现象，却证明了一种古老的天性。
Yes!
That's pretty good.
Well done, Howard. Look at that.
家庭生活驱动着中国文化的方方面面，但对一个家庭的爱并不只限于在世的家庭成员，在中国祖先们也同样重要。
Ancestor worship, that was already a big thing in China during the Bronze Age, long before Confucius promoted it. And today, a reverence for one's ancestors, it remains of central importance to the whole Chinese concept of family life.
我想要了解这一切对中国文化和艺术的影响，于是我来到了位于人民广场的上海博物馆。这里珍藏着14万多件中国文物精品。我来这里看一件国宝级的珍品，它并不是珍贵的瓷器，而是一尊有着3000多年历史的青铜鼎。这是中国人尊崇先祖的一个有力象征。这口鼎被称之为大克鼎。
I tell you what's completely remarkable when you come and see this ding up close is the intricacy of the decoration, because, you know, this is a big object. It's colossal. Yet that's offset by all of this embellishment. Have a look on the two cooking handles on either side. Here's this interlaced pattern. Feels to a Western audience like it could be almost Celtic.It actually consists of different dragons that are overlapping, one on top of the other. It gives it this really dynamic, pulsing, sort of writhing energy. These ritual bronze vessels, they develop this green patina. But think about when this was originally cast. It would have been golden, shiny, all of those pulsing lines sparkling. It probably would have been cast and used in an ancestral temple to honor the gods, to honor one's ancestors, and cooked food would have appeared inside the ding. And we do know, in fact, who commissioned it, because there's this long inscription. You have 290 characters. I mean, really, it's a historical document. It's one that transforms the ding into a family heirloom.
这个铭文上面它显示了，就是拥有这件鼎的主人，他的名字叫克，所以在商代的话，他是孤。
韦新莹博士是上海博物馆青铜部的副研究馆员。
比较多。那么在周，他这个鼎其实是为他的这个先祖施华富，就是纪念这个施华富来做的。
Was it the case then that ancestors were considered, were worshipped as gods?
在中国呢？祖先他不说成是神，可是呢，他拥有某些能力，譬如说呢，他能够庇荫他的子孙，这样的一种能力，类似像神，但我们不把他说成是神。然后呢，借由这个食物的香气。这个香气飘到天上，然后就能够让这个祖先呢，然后能够降下来享用这些食物。
我发现这一点挺神奇的。作为一件艺术品，这口充满传奇色彩的鼎，只有在盛满香气扑鼻的祭品时，才会完全绽放它的光彩。中国文化中生者与亡者之间的牵绊，在铸造大克鼎的工艺和技术中得到了印证。我想知道，在当代的中国，人们对于先祖的尊崇是否依然存在？因此，我离开上海，前往湖南省的宝盖镇。我受邀来到廖家宗祠，每年数以百计的家庭成员会在中国的法定假期，也就是清明节，回到这里祭祀他们的祖先。这比我期待中的更加热闹和令人激动。
This festival is becoming more and more joyous.
It feels like there's an air of anticipation,
yeah.
and jubilation.
It's like a party. It's like a Chinese Thanksgiving.
23岁的彭明高读的是社科专业，他刚从美国毕业回国。他的外公是廖家的大家长。明高会给我讲解今天的仪式。
Is the idea that the ancestors are actually being sort of summoned into the hall?
Yes.
So they're in the sort of spirit realm generally,
mm-hmm.
and then at this moment, this is a sacred place. The fireworks, the oration, the music, the firecrackers.
To welcome them, to alert with ancestors that the ritual is about to begin. So wake them up. And the second point is to scare away and to ward off some like evil spirits,
I see.
which may be lurking around.
Hello, hi.
Hi.
明高的妈妈朝晖，非常想让我能全身心地参与到整个仪式中来。
Oh, is this for me?
Yeah, this is for you.
Are you sure? I'm not really Alistair Liao for the day.
Alistair Liao, yes.
Thank you.
整个体验令人陶醉，让我感受特别强烈。鞭炮声和喧闹的音乐制造了些许嘈杂，但是毫无疑问， 这对于明高和他的家族来说，是一段亲密且特别的时光。我非常荣幸能成为其中的一员。还有，鼎就在祭坛的正前方，虽然和上海博物馆里那件圆形的不同，但确实是一口鼎。
I'm standing here in 2019, and there's a ding in front of the altar, a shrine to the ancestors. And a few days ago, I was with the darker ding, and that was made at the start of the first millennium BC. So to have this sense from antiquity to the present day, an unbroken chain, something which transcends our everyday worldly concerns,It's really moving. It's really, really special to see.
在祠堂之外，我们去扫墓，摆放鲜花和祭品。
And the idea is that we burn paper money at each tomb?
Yes.
扫墓完毕之后，是时候家庭聚餐了。
This is the top table.
Yes.
And all the food's being served. Who sits there?
The spirits of ancestors. So actually, we believe that.Ancestors will come here and join us to have lunch together. So we prepare all kinds of their favorite foods.
Yes. So we're honored to be sitting so close to the top table.
Yeah, so we are blessed.
Yes.
Yeah.
Excellent.
在这个值得纪念的下午，我们充分致敬了这些神灵嘉宾。
So we just tuck in now.
Great.
Yeah.
但仅仅怀念先人，还不足以让清明节一直持续下去。有能力随着时代变迁去调整和适应，才能让传统习俗历久弥新，焕发活力。当天晚上，明高向我展示了他们家族非常珍贵的族谱。
This is the family history.
Yes, of the past 44 generations.
44 generations, gosh.
今天，他的母亲廖昭辉。和他外婆傅幼仙的名字被添加了上去。
This entry of my mom.
Ah, that's you.
在整个家族约800年的历史中，他们是被载入族谱的第一代女性。
He was born in 1936.
如果你问我的话，我会说这又是值得祖先们好好庆祝一番的事情。接下来，我将去欣赏一件超乎想象的精美文物。我还会被邀请参加一个极为神圣的仪式。
There we go.
幸好我带了领带，我要去参加一场中国婚礼。我来到了位于中国东部的杭州。传说中的西子湖畔城市，我来这里探索艺术、祖先和家庭之间的古老联系。自从宋代诗人苏轼把西湖比作四大美女之一，这个熙熙攘攘的旅游景点就多了一分爱情与浪漫的味道。浙江省博物馆就在西湖边上，这里珍藏着一系列最能展现中国传统婚礼特色的文物。 万宫轿，一顶奢华的朱金漆木雕花轿，据说打造它耗费了上万个工时。
If you've ever encountered something more lavish, more luxurious than this bridal sedan chair, then I'd really like to hear about it, because for me, this is, I think, without question, the most OTT embellished, splendiferous piece of bling I think I've ever seen.
这顶金色轿子要由八人来抬，这也是整个十里红妆的焦点所在。在婚礼当天，新娘家用它来向众人展示财力和权势。那绝对是一个非凡的场景。
I mean, if you look at this passage here with all of these beautiful tassels and pieces of cut glass, and beneath you can then see there's a hanging pagoda above, these different dragons with bats and four boys resting on the dragons' heads. But the thing that is perhaps quite surprising, in amongst all of these symbolic pieces of fruit and insects and creatures and these operatic scenes, is you can spend as long as you like studying them all, and what you won't find is a pair of young lovers enamored of one another.
研究员范佩林已经写了好几本关于中国婚俗和漆器的书，他正在帮助我理解这顶轿子真正的含义。
其实，在我们中国古代，就是一对男女的结合，更重要的是，两个家族的结合，就有钱的变得更加，这有权的变得更加强大。他们就是不一定特别的讲究爱情。我的外婆她结婚就是做了花轿，用了十里红妆。我记得我小时候，如果是就说我的外公跟她开玩笑或者吵架，我的外婆就会很自豪地说：“我是十里红妆嫁过来的，就是你不能欺负我。”
I see. That was that part of the point of it then.
对的，对的。因为在中国古代，就是男女地位可能是不平等，但是就是说新娘的爸爸妈妈就是怕她的女儿在丈夫家里她受欺负，所以就把她所需要的所有的东西，就小的一直到一根针一根线给她这个送给她，就是免得她在丈夫家里就受欺负。
对我来说，十里红妆和朱金木雕花轿离当代中国有十万八千里。现在我要离开城区，前往杭州的一个古老茶园。明天早上，一对当地的小两口，方正和思佳，将在这里举行婚礼。
I can remember on my wedding day, the day before was a very exciting day.
Yeah,
it's also slightly stressful. There's quite a lot to do.
和其他很多年轻人一样，他们俩其实早已领了结婚证，但是向亲戚朋友们公开宣告他们的结合，对双方家庭来说十分重要。
How traditional or not is the ceremony tomorrow going to be?
It's like half traditional, like it's
like a combination of the two.
Yeah,
I mean, you're not arriving in a sedan chair.
Yes, I think it's.Too traditional. It's like I'm too passive.
So then we choose a more ancient version of it,
which is
the removing of the fan. She will come.
I'm holding the fan like this, and everybody can see my face.
Right.
And my father is with me. So if I'm pleased, I'll take off the fan. If I'm not, I'll go away.
You turn. Oh my God! There's some real jeopardy here. Okay. Why is it so important for you both to have these traditional elements within the ceremony?
It's like, I think Western people tend to believe in God, but I think Chinese people tend to believe in our ancestors' wisdom. Yes.
I think you're much more mature than I was when I got married. Ah. In the sense, I thought it was all about us, but it isn't. It's about the whole family.
Yeah.
I think family is like the most basic unit ofChinese society, and I think it's also the most important unit of Chinese society.
Do you need some help?
好了好了。
皮卡兹。
几点？
I've never been to a Chinese wedding before, and having been part of these preparations yesterday in a small way, I'm really excited now to see what the ceremony is actually like. And I've heard that it's customary in China to give the bride and groom a present in the form of money. So I have this red envelope.And inside, some crisp banknotes, because I believe it's polite for them to be crisp. And of course, they have to be red, because red is the auspicious color, wishing good fortune and prosperity upon the happy couple.
Que shan. Que shan
的礼仪始于唐朝。
At the core of any wedding the world over is this real depth, this truth and sincerity of emotion. And the thing that fascinated me about this particular ceremony was how eclectic it was. You could call it the ultimate postmodern wedding, because Scarlet and Badger, they took this supremely stylish pick and mix approach to all of the different traditions and customs from Chinese weddings through the ages.
新婚快乐
So I think the expectations, the pressures from society and family, they still linger, they're still present. But this couple, at least, they clearly felt free to invent new traditions of their own.
Next episode, 我将探索在中国文化中被称作诗书画三绝之一的书法，我将欣赏中国最早且最珍贵的书法作品之一，并体验一堂由当代中国书法老师亲授的书法课。
漂亮！
我还会去故宫，在这座中国顶尖的博物馆里，欣赏一件令人惊叹的真正的中国杰作。